Hi everyone, right behind me are four container farms. Today I want to walk you through the pros and cons of this way of growing food. Let's start with the water hookups. Over here you've got two inlets, two outlets, and one overflow pipe. Just connect them to the outside system, and that's it. Super simple. Now for the power. All the plugs are at the back of the container. This here is the climate control unit. Connecting power is really straightforward. One plug runs the lights and irrigation. The other one powers the climate system. The great thing is you can set these farms up almost anywhere. On an empty lot, a rooftop, a parking area, or even unused grassland. When it comes to approvals, what usually matters is building safety and fire codes. Since these are considered mobile buildings, the approval process is often much quicker and easier. Most people start with just one container to test if the business model works. Of course, electricity costs and crop prices vary by country, so whether it's profitable really depends on local conditions. We can also help clients run the numbers to check feasibility. Once the first one proves itself, you can easily scale up, either link several containers side by side, or if space is tight, stack them vertically. That's the beauty of container farms, they're super scalable. And if the landowner ever needs the site back, no problem, you can move the farm to a new location anytime. Relocation is very convenient. Another big plus, no matter if you're in a burning hot desert or a freezing cold climate, a container farm can still grow crops year-round, totally unaffected by outside weather. Inside, there are five growing layers with fast growth cycles. The output can be up to 100 times higher than traditional farmland. And compared with soil farming, you only need about 1% of the water and fertilizer. But of course, it's not all perfect, because everything inside has to be precisely controlled. Climate, nutrients, CO2, lighting. These farms rely on lots of advanced hardware and sensors. That makes the setup cost pretty high. So container farms only really make sense in places where electricity is relatively cheap and crops can sell for a good price. If your goal is simply to test indoor farming in a new location, then this is an excellent way to do it. One more thing, indoor farming requires different know-how compared to outdoor farming. Outdoors, it's all about adapting to the weather. Indoors, it's about creating the right conditions for growth. Of course, our system comes with built-in strategies and data to help you manage crops more easily. But overall, indoor farming takes more specialized knowledge. And in the next video, I'll show you what really makes a good container farm.